Good evening. Welcome to Northeast Web Shots. You are watching Northeast Web Shots Evening Daily Bulletin. This is Anudeep Sharma. Here are the headlines of the day. Starting off with the national news. India crosses 91 crore mark milestone in COVID-19 vaccination drive. Prime Minister Modi inaugurated 3-day urban conclave in Lucknow today. Prime Minister laid the foundation stones of 75 urban projects or schemes. The centre has planned to introduce a higher penalty and jail term for cruelty against animals. A bill to amend the existing law is also likely to be passed in the next parliament session. Karnataka government will soon hold discussions with Andhra Pradesh and Telangana on constructing a parallel balancing reservoir over Tungabhadra River to desert it, an issue which involved both the states. Kerala, the Indian Meteorological Department IMD has issued a red alert for the hilly Idukki district of Kerala on October 5th and an orange alert to Pathanamitta, Kottayam, Palakkad and Malappuram districts on Monday and Tuesday for heavy rains. Maharashtra, Mumbai Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj International Airport domestic passenger terminal T1 to reopen from October 20th. Manipur, a drone delivers vaccine in Manipur, India's first to do so in Southeast Asia. The country's top medical body, ICMR, successfully delivered the jabs from Manipur's Bishnupur via Loktak Lake to the Karang Island. Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, Punjab Congress leader Navjot Singh Sidhu and other opposition leaders condemned the violence in Uttar Pradesh, Lakhimpur Kheri, where 8 people, including 4 farmers, were killed in a protest against 2 BJP ministers. Violence broke out on 3rd of October in Lakhimpur Kheri, where farmers were holding protest since this morning over the visit of Union Minister of State for Home Ajay Mishra and Deputy Chief Minister Keshav Maurya. Lakhimpur violence, Uttar Pradesh government, farm leaders reach agreement 45 lakh ex gratia for a kin of each deceased, 10 lakh each for injured. Kangana Ranaut becomes brand ambassador of Uttar Pradesh government's One District, One Product ODOP scheme. Punjab Congress leader Navjot Singh Sidhu again demanded the replacement of Punjab's police chief and advocate general on Sunday, saying otherwise the ruling party in the state will suffer a loss of face. Tamil Nadu, as a tribute to the young freedom fighter Kodi Khata Kumarun on his birth anniversary, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister M.K. Stalin on 4th of October named an arterial road opposite to the Erode electorate after Kumarun. Tamil Nadu Chief Minister M.K. Stalin has written to his counterparts in 11 known Bharatiya Janata Party ruled states and Goa, seeking the support to oppose the national eligibility cum entrance test and restore the primacy of states in education. West Bengal, an All India Organization of Ration Dealers, has filed a petition in the Supreme Court against the Duare Ration, Ration at Your Doors, project of West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee. According to the reports, they consider the policy as absurd and non-implementable. Now coming towards the defense news, Air Marshal Amit Dev, AVSM, VSM, ADC, assumed the appointment of Air Officer Commanding-in-Chief, AOC-in-C, of Western Air Command on 4th of October 21. Air Marshal B.R. Krishna assumed charge of Chief of Integrated Defence Staff to the Chairman, Chiefs of Staff Committee on October 1, 2021. Major General Smita Devrani assumed charge as Additional Director General of Military Nursing Service on October 1, 2021. The deal coincided with the occasion of 96th MNS Corps Day. 89th Indian Air Force Day to be celebrated on 8th of October 2021. The Indian Army has successfully tested Made in India K9 Vajra howitzers in high altitude locations in eastern Ladakh. Defence Secretary Dr. Ajay Kumar launched a website for Republic Day celebrations 2022 to showcase the Republic Day celebrations, which will mark the 75th year of independence, Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. Ministry of Defence has created a new website, www.indiannrdcmod.gov.in. The website will be a single point official source for all the content related to Republic Day celebrations. Coming towards the international news, Pandora Papers leaked the secret of deals and hidden assets of some of the world's richest and most powerful people have been revealed in biggest trove of leaked offshore data in the history. Cases pertaining to Pandora Papers will be investigated and appropriate action will be taken in such cases as per law, Finance Ministry stated. The names of several Indian businessmen, celebrities and politicians have been revealed in an unprecedented leak of financial documents, Pandora Papers. As many as 380 Indians are on the list of global elite who have been exposed for ring-fencing their wealth through shadowy financial transactions and using offshore tax havens to hide assets worth millions of dollars. The 40th edition of India International Trade Fair 2021 will be held on the 14th to 27th November at Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. Now jumping towards the world news, Fumio Kishida to be sworn in as the Prime Minister of Japan. David Julius and Adrian Patapotchian from United States, scientists who discovered how our bodies feel the warmth of the sun or the hug of a loved one, have won the Nobel Prize. They shared the 2021 Prize in Medicine or Physiology for their work on sensing touch and temperature. The Asian Development Bank, ADB, and the government of Bangladesh signed the agreement for United States dollars $400 million in loan for constructing the Dhaka-Shilliat Highway to improve mobility, road safety and regional trade in the Northeast Economic Corridor in Bangladesh. Pakistan PM Imran Khan is facing flak after he said that his government started talks with some groups of the banned Tariq-e-Taliban Pakistan with the aim of having the group lay down their weapons. In Italy, a small private plane crashed into an empty building in Milan, killing all 8 people on board on 3rd of October. The plane, which took off from Milan's Linate City Airport, was headed for the Italian island of Sardinia. The crash occurred just outside a suburban metro station. The pilot was Romanian billionaire Dan Petrescu. He died alongside his wife and their son. China-Pakistan hold first joint anti-terror exercise under the ambit of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization's Regional Anti-Terrorism Structure, concluded on the 4th of October, with the participation of troops from China and Pakistan sharing their experiences to counter evolving threats. The closing ceremony of the Joint Anti-Terrorist Exercise 2021 was held at National Counter-Terrorism Center. Now coming towards the end, COVID update national. India recorded 18,346 fresh COVID-19 infections in the last 24 hours, the lowest in over 6 months, the Union Health Ministry informed on Tuesday. With this, the active caseload for the country stands at 2,52,902, according to the Health Ministry, accounting for the less than 1% of the total cases. This much for today. For more updates, keep following Northeast Web Shots. Thank you. Good night.